I'm going to show you how to do a front carry with your Beko Gemini. So this is the Beko Gemini core. It's the mesh version of the full cotton. And this is the full cotton one. So on the old style Beko Geminis, you have a tri-lock on the buckle. So to open them, you need to press that little bit. And then you can open this one. So you can do it together at the same time. And then it will come undone. On the newer style, like on my Beko Cool, you don't have the tri-lock anymore. You have just a normal buckle that you bring through clip like that. It's a bit easier to use. You also have dual adjust, so you can either pull forward to tighten or pull back. On the older style Gemini, you just pull back only. So I'm gonna demo both. So first of all, we're gonna start with the Beko Cool. So you're going to bring your waist belt on your waist and clip on your back. To release it, you just press with the older style. Again, it's a tri-lock, so you need to press this bit and then the second bit. So it's the same in terms of how you put it on. So always on your waist. And because the panels are quite tall with the Beko Geminis, if your baby's still quite small, it's quite good to have it quite high up on your waist. And you're going to bring your baby on your chest and then just let your baby drop a little bit. Kind of bring the bum over the waist belt and then bring that panel over the back like this, okay? Because if you sit your baby high with your waist belt low, this is what's going to happen. The face will be covered. So waist belt high with very small babies and sitting in a nice deep seat into the panel until you find the top of the panel arrives kind of under the earlobe. Now I'm going to cross straps to demo, so I'm going to hold my baby. I'm going to grab a strap, flip it over my shoulder, switch hand, I'm going to hold baby across the back. With my other hand, I grab the strap and here pull down and bring the strap across. And always do this movement because that will stop the cross going into your neck, which is a bit uncomfortable. So for this carrier, I've got my safety with my elastic band, so bring it through. The elastic band like this. Zoop. Try to remember to do that, it's quite important. I'm gonna clip. I'm gonna do just a real quick tightening like this for safety. Flip the other one over, grab, pull down and bring across. And then I'm gonna do the same here. Bring the clip through the elastic band and clip. To tighten with cross straps, best way to do it is to do the towel thing. So imagine you toweling your back. You lift the slack off your shoulder, you follow it around, and then you retighten. So if you have dual adjust, you can either pull forward like that, or you can pull back, okay? And I'm gonna do the same on the other side. So I'm gonna just lift it off. Stops it from going into my neck, pull it around, and I'm gonna pull forward. Which I prefer, I can pull back. Make sure your baby's still in a good position. You can see airways at all time. It's got headrest, so if you need to support the head a bit more, you can use this, but what's gonna happen is that the head will be covered. So headrest is really handy as your baby grows and you need a little bit more support, or if they fall asleep, if you're back carrying, you need a bit more of head support because these don't have hoods. If you want one with the hood, you need to get the Beko 8, which is the bigger version of it. So just leave it down. As long as the top of the panel is right under the earlobe, then you're good to go. As simple as that, you don't really need to do anything else. That's it, okay? So I'm gonna show you the version with the straight strap. So to take my baby out, I'm just gonna loosen on each side and I can just take baby out. I can take one arm out if I want and lift baby out. Or I can just support my baby and just unclip and just stick that side out. Totally up to you how you do it. Everybody got their own little method. Okay, so if I want to do cross straps, so I'll demo with the other version. Unclip again on your waist. Like that. Clip. Retighten. And So you won't be crossing those straps this time, so you would need to use the chest strap, which is that little clip that goes between the straps that stops them falling off your shoulders. So you can just pre-clip, bring it over like this, and then you're gonna bring your baby on your shoulder. That's one way to do it, and you can just slide your baby in like that. And again, let your baby's bum drop over the waist belt so that you've got some good positioning here. I'm going to retighten, so I can just pull like that, but I find it feels a bit nicely, a bit more snug if I just lift the slack off my shoulder, bring that slack forward, and then pull. Just going to do it like this, and it stops also the straps going straight into my boobs. If I'm a breastfeeding mum, it's just very uncomfortable, so just like guiding it down like that until you feel it's nice and snug, and then you retighten. Not over tighten, as that can arch the back and put a bit of pressure on the back. Okay, safety, sling is nice and tight, baby's close enough to kiss, I can see the airway, so nose and mouth are always visible and clear. I can fit two fingers between chin and chest when my baby is asleep, and that's important. And it's really comfortable. So taking my baby out, I can just loosen, lift, and then grab the strap like this to unclip. Or I can just loosen and then lift my baby out. I can just take one clip off, whatever works for you. Just find your own technique. If you don't like sliding your baby, you can just pre-clip, loosen your straps on each side to make it quite loose. And we can do the t-shirt method. So you bring your baby on your chest, check your baby's close enough to kiss, bum lower than the knees, and you can just bring the paddle across, grab the chest strap, bring it over your head, keep holding baby, arms through, on each side, like that. And then again, you just feed the slack to the front and you retighten like that. Always, always carry your baby upright, not in a cradle style. It's very important as well to make sure the airways are clear. So play around, see what you prefer, straight strap or cross strap. It's very personal. Just see what works for you after a long walk, what feels more comfortable. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.